In this video, I'm going to show you how to unlock the power and uniqueness of using custom fonts on your website. Now, this is going to be for people using the Astra theme. However, hopefully in the future, other theme developers will use this same method to make it super easy to add custom fonts to their WordPress themes. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress videos for non-techies. If you enjoy the content in this video, consider clicking on that subscribe button. And if you'd like video notifications, there's a little bell off to the right of that. Click on that. YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. We're talking about the Astra theme, which is also the theme that I'm using on my website. Now, I'm going through a revamping of a lot of different things on my website. Part of that is adding custom fonts to my website to make it look a little more unique. And fonts is something that most websites, we kind of limit ourselves to just the available Google fonts, but there are so much better web fonts out there, not web fonts, just fonts out there. And especially if you come from a print background where you're used to using different fonts and different print materials, you might find just Google fonts are a little on the limiting side. And there's a lot of times where you might want to use custom fonts on your website. This is especially helpful if maybe you have a restaurant website or some website involving kids or gaming or something along those lines. Maybe not just your standard business website, but something where you need to add a little bit of uniqueness to it. And that's where custom fonts come in. Now, if you're using the Astra theme, they released a new plugin recently called Custom Fonts. And you can actually install this directly in WordPress. All you have to do is go to Plugins, Add New, and do a quick search for custom fonts. And it's going to pop up right away. Or you could just do a search for Astra. Let's see. Actually, I've never searched it this way by searching for custom fonts. Looks like a million other things come up. But if you would just go ahead and instead enter Astra, and when you hit Astra, you see all of the different plugins that are available for Astra. And you can see right here, it's brand new. It's called Custom Fonts, and it makes it insanely simple to add custom fonts to your WordPress website. And I'm going to show you how to do it right now. So if you've downloaded, installed, and activated this plugin and you go to Appearance, you're going to see a new option called Custom Fonts. Now, let me preface this for a second and say adding custom fonts to your website, if you know how to code, add custom functions and queuing scripts and all that kind of stuff, yeah, sorry if I lost you. You could do this already, you know, you're just putting your custom code in. But if you're like the other 99.999% of us, this plugin will definitely help you, especially if you're using the Astra theme. It is so easy. All you have to do is give the font a name and then you can upload it. And there's these different formats that fonts usually come in. Now, what you're going to want is a font in this TTF format. And I'll put this link in the video description box that explains the difference between these various formats. It basically, the main difference is compatibility with different web browsers. And the font format you're going to want is the TTF format. It's going to be the most compatible with the most web browsers. But I'll leave a link to this if you can only get a font in OTF or WOFF format. That's going to be okay. You'll just realize the limitations, but you're going to want it in TTF format. Now, you can go to Google and search for free fonts. I did this search right here as well. Free fonts, and a whole bunch of websites come up. One of them is The Font. It's the one that I downloaded a font from earlier. Now, I'm not positive on how the licensing works on all of this. These are free fonts. Some of them, they say it's just free. Some of them say, hey, why don't you shoot me a donation? Because these are all custom fonts made by people. But any place where you could purchase a font, you can use that font. You just want to get it in TTF format. So let's see. I could see maybe this for a... That's actually a really cool font right here. Let's see if it's in TTF format, script handwritten. I'm going to go ahead and download it and just see what happens. This High Tide font, I think that looks pretty cool. So I'm going to go ahead and click on download. It is downloading to my computer. Now let me open up. It downloads as a zip file. So let me go ahead and open this zip file. Okay, I just unzipped it. It's on my desktop and it looks like it's a TTF format. And so I'm going to go ahead and install it, see what happens. So So I'm going to go ahead and click back to custom fonts. I'll give this that name, the High Tide. You can obviously name it whatever you want. Okay, and then I have my file here. I'm going to drag and drop it right here where it says TTF. Actually, I think I have to go ahead and click on upload and select it. Okay, now that I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and click add new font, and now I have it listed right here. So I've got my High Tide font, and this is one that I added earlier called Wowzers. So now let me show you how easy it is to now go ahead and use this custom font. So what you're going to want to do is, depending on the page builder you're using, I have Elementor installed on this site, and in Elementor there's a specific setting that says in Elementor use the fonts that I set with the theme, and you're going to want to go ahead and do that. So it says right here, disable global fonts. You're going to want to go ahead and check this box, click on save changes. So now I'm going to go into appearance and customize. I want to jump into the customizer, and so you could see when it pulls up here, okay, so here is that custom font I threw in called Wowzers, but I'm going to change this right now to that High Tide one and just see what it looks like. So I have this typography option. I'm going to click there, and then I'm going to choose base typography, and then right here for headings I had it set to that Wowzers, but when you click on it you now have this custom section, and here is that other custom font I uploaded. I don't know what's going to happen. I'm going to choose it and let's see if that changes, and there it is. Now obviously it's a little on the small side, that's why you want to play around with these things and test them out, but you can see I've installed a new custom font and it was that easy. Now let me go ahead and save this and let me go back into the back end of WordPress. Now where you're really going to unlock the power of these custom fonts is if you have the Astra Pro package. It has a expanded list of options for fonts that you can choose for various areas like menus and things of that nature. So I'm going to go ahead and activate that now and show you what that looks like. I'm going to go to plugins. I'm going to click on activate for Astra Pro. Now that brings a bunch of modules that I can enable and extensions that I can enable just the ones I want. And I access them by going to appearance Astra, and then I click on add-ons, and here they all are. So I'm just going to enable the typography one right here. And now that that's activated, I'm going to go ahead into the customizer. And now when I select on typography right here, we're going to see more options of different settings where I can choose the font for specific areas on the website. So before we didn't have this primary menu option, but I can choose it. And now I can change the font for the menu area. So I can click on the font family here and I can choose Wowzers if I wanted to. And it's going to change it to that Wowzers font I had uploaded when I tested it out. You see how this brings a custom look to the website just by doing something as simple as putting in a custom font. I can see what High Tide looks like. It's kind of scrunched down. I think I would have to really increase the size of it to be able to see it better, just like that. So let's see. I could play around with it to see if I can make it look the way that I want it to look. But you get to the point here how easy it is to add these custom fonts to the various locations on your website. Let's take a look at some of the other options that we get with Astra Pro for the fonts. So when I click on base typography now, I still get my headings and the body content area, but if I click on content, now I can choose a unique font for each of the different headings. And so H1, H2, all the way down to H6. So a good strategy here is, say the H5 and the H6, you can put different fonts that you might want to use more sparingly. You know, a perfect example, you might see this a lot of times where you have your main font and your main heading, and then maybe above or below it you have some cursive font or something like that to make it just stand out a little bit and have a bit more of design to it. You can assign H5 and H6 to different fonts that you might want to use sparingly, and then when you're building out your content in your page builder, you can, for the areas that you want to use these particular fonts, you could just change the H style for those different things right there. So that is that, and let me actually just demonstrate that just to show you. So if I wanted to use the High Tide, and I'll make this an H6 right here, I'm probably going to want to make that much larger like this. So now I'm assigning High Tide to a heading 6, and let's say heading 5 I'm going to assign as Wowzers, and I might want that to be, say, say 25 pixels. I'll go ahead and do a save and publish. I'll get out of here. And then let me go into pages. And for the home page, I'm going to go ahead and click on edit with Elementor. Same would be if you're using Beaver Builder or any other page builder where you get to choose when you click on a bit of text if it's going to be one of these headings. So I have this heading right here. When I click on it, I can choose style. And then right here, it's statically set to Montserrat. But instead, I can go here to default, and then I will go back here to content, and here I can choose it from H1 to one of those different other options. So if I wanted to change the font, I can easily do it right here by changing this HTML tag. So I know for the H5 tag, I use that Wowzers font. So if I click on that, then I get the Wowzers font, and I can go and I can also change the size right here if I wanted to in my page builder. So anyways, this is how easy it is to add some custom fonts to your WordPress theme if you're using Astra. Now, if you're not using Astra, that's okay. You can ask your theme developer to make this plugin work with their theme. But I really love the direction that Astra is going in making these things that will really enable you to make a unique website that visually looks stunning, to make it super easy as simply as uploading a new font file. And fonts, unfortunately, are one of those areas that a lot of web designers may neglect. But if you would just get used to customizing things and using custom fonts and custom colors, things that are just not with a base installation, say if you're using a template, you're going to be able to make websites that truly stand out. And with such a wide selection of fonts, especially if you're making a restaurant website or all these different websites where you would really highly benefit by using custom fonts, I really love how the Astra theme is making it so easy to do that. So I know for me, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start using some custom fonts on my website. If you have any suggestions of fonts that you love, I'd love to hear about those. And maybe if you have some suggestions for me of some fonts that may look great on my website, go ahead and if you could leave it in the comment section down below, maybe some of your favorite font pairings in the comment section down below. Hey, thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.